It's time for the Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast. Powerful and liberating business strategies you can start in 5 minutes or less. Now, here's your host, Dean Soto.
Hey, this is Dean Soto, founder of freedominfiveminutes.com and prosulum.com, prosulum.com. And we're here again with another Freedom in 5 Minutes episode. Today's topic is this. Please stop picking my brain. It's gross. That and more coming up. All right, we're here again with another frosty morning in Central California. Love it. Love it. So good. Beats 90 degree weather in the morning. Oh, so good to be out here. So, gosh, this was 3 weeks ago? Has to be. Yeah, probably 3, maybe even 4 weeks ago. So I got this text message from a friend of mine. And a little background story is that this friend actually used to work for me. This friend worked for me doing, he used to do my podcasts, and he was the podcast host for a while on another thing that I was doing. I actually outsourced my entire podcast situation, which was really cool. It worked out really well, but he moved on. He moved on to work with some other folks, and I want to say maybe a year ago, we got back in touch, and he was looking for another position, and not with my company, but with a relatively big nonprofit organization. And I ended up helping him with a referral recommendation. I ended up talking with the person who was doing the hiring and gave him good reviews and stuff, because the guy was good and you know, a decent friend and everything like that. So I always want to help people out. Well, a couple weeks ago, so I hadn't heard from him in a while. He actually ended up getting the job, which was awesome. You know, he just had a baby, and his wife just had a baby, and it worked out really well. He was able to you know, move on to the next level, right? Well, a few weeks ago, he texts me out of the blue, and this is not the only person who has done this, but he texts me out of the blue and said that he ended up getting another position with a really well-known church organization, and he was the marketing director for that particular church's music group. Very, very popular in the Christian circles music group. And because of that, he's the marketing director, and he was looking for additional channels to get their music into different locations and so on and so forth. But in the text it was basically, hey Dean, you know, give an update and everything like that. And at the very end, he says, I would love to pick your brain about the different channels we can use to market our music. And immediately I was like, yeah, I'll get to you later. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to respond to you. Because in a couple of things. One, in the past, whenever I've let people, quote unquote, pick my brain, it's never worked out in my favor. just think about it. Anytime you would let somebody pick your brain, just like pick, you know, hey Dean, can I pick your nose for a little bit? I just need to figure some things out. Does that sound like a beneficial situation? Yeah, maybe. You have a clean nose, but it's also kind of gross, right? Same thing goes with picking your brain. What value am I getting out of that? Not that I want to always, you know, get something back for helping other people, but immediately, in my opinion, it's, hey, let me take from you. Let me take all of the experience, all of the heartache, all of the challenges, all of the things that you've learned, all of the thousands and thousands of dollars that you've invested and lost, the wins, the losses, everything. Can I just take all of the good stuff from you so that it benefits me? Now, does that sound like a win-win situation? And so I literally have not responded to him. And I've done that to the past to other people. Do I still like the guy? Of course. This happens quite a bit. Especially with people who are just starting out their business and they're friends, and they're like, hey, Dean, you've been in business since, 2009. Even before that, doing some side stuff since, for over a decade. Let me pick your brain. I just started my business. Let me pick your brain and give you no value back whatsoever because I'm a new business owner and I have no value that I could potentially give you other than money, which I probably don't even have, right? And even if I did have it, I wouldn't know how much your value is because I'm a new business owner. And while I might be sounding a little sarcastic, I don't mean to be. The idea that it's okay to ask if you can pick someone's brain is so backward. Why would you ever think that that's okay? Why would you ever think that that would be okay? And so why is this important? It's important to realize that any good relationship requires giving, not just taking. Giving, right? What are you giving to the situation? What's the value you are bringing, right? This goes for new clients. This goes for new customers. This goes for prospects. What are you giving? So for example, with prospects, what are you giving in the very beginning? People who are wanting to get a VSA through ProSulum, when they schedule a discovery call, they get asked a series of questions, and it looks like those questions are taking, right? It looks like you get asked what your industry is, do you have standard operating procedures, is everything scalable, yada yada yada, a whole bunch of different questions, and 10 questions in all. And it looks like it's taking, but in fact, what's going on is it's giving. The person right away can tell, is this right for me? Do I even need this? And if they do need it, they're like, holy crap, I actually do need this because I don't have standard operating procedures. I don't have automation in my business. I don't have scalability. If I stop working, I lose lots of money. Immediately, it's giving a perspective so that when they do get on the phone, it's a good fit and it's not wasting their time. And it's not wasting my time, right? And even if it's not totally a good fit, it's still not wasting time because they know what to expect. It's a better conversation. right? So what are you bringing to your relationships? Because this is not just business. What are you bringing to your marriage? What are you bringing to your relationship with your kids? What are you bringing? Like, what are you bringing to your relationship with your friends? Or are you just picking your wife's emotional brain or your husband's emotional brain? Or are you just picking your kids' brains? Or are you just taking? What do you give? How many love notes do you give in a week to your family? How many love texts, videos, things like that do you give without asking for anything? How many times are you giving gifts to your clients during the year as your way of saying thank you? You know, they're giving you money and you're giving them value back, but how many times are you appreciating them and not just taking them for granted? Right? How many times are you doing that? Stop picking people's brains. It's a bad habit. So how, right now, what are you doing right now that is simply taking from other people? Maybe you're just taking from the church. Maybe you haven't tithed in years. Or if you do, it's like $10 in the basket for the year when you've made $200,000. Maybe it's taking from the church. They have to pay their bills. Unless you're doing something home study online or something like that, they have to pay for that fixed cost. They have to pay to keep the lights on, to keep the fellowship going. What's the percentage that you've donated? What are you taking? I just want you to this week, see where you're taking. That's it. And then you'll have at least the information that you need to then make a decision on what you want to do so that you're starting to give value. All right, this is Dean Soto, Freedom in 5 Minutes. Go check out freedominfiveminutes.com. Or if you want a virtual systems architect, someone who you can literally show how to do something in 5 minutes, they will clone you. They will document that entire thing for you and then do it, which is crazy. So every 5 minutes you spend is freedom. Freedom in 5 minutes. You can literally transform your entire business in 30 days, 5 minutes a day. All right, this is Dean Soto, freedominfiveminutes.com. Go check that out, and prosulum.com, prosulum.com. And I'll see you in the next Freedom in 5 Minutes episode.
Thanks for listening to the Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast. Now, head over to www.freedominfiveminutes.com and register for our free masterclass and discover how to start systemizing and automating your entire business 5 minutes at a time. We'll see you next time on the Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast.